After a brief discussion on special relativity in an introduction, now we are going to discuss the concept of reference frame. Actually, you know, the concept of motion is a relative concept. And in classical mechanics and relativistic mechanics, we deal with motion of a particle or a system. So it is necessary to know about the reference frame before discussing either the classical mechanics or the relativistic mechanics. So first of all, before starting the chapter on special relativity, it is essential to deal with the idea of reference frame. When you say reference frame, what does it mean? Actually, a reference frame is any body assumed to be fixed in absolute rest, relative to which position and state of motion of other bodies is described. It means whenever you want to know what is the position of a body and what is its state of motion, that is, what is its speed or velocity, what is its acceleration, definitely these parameters can be determined in terms of or relative to some other bodies. So a body relative to which we find these parameters is actually known as reference frame. Actually, the idea of reference frame is not unique. In fact, any body of this universe can be treated as a reference frame. So this reference frame is actually represented by a rectangular coordinate system. You can see in this figure that I have assumed a rectangular coordinate system having the coordinate axes OX, OY and OZ. And actually we associate a reference frame S with this coordinate system. And if you want to associate this coordinate system or this reference frame with any body, let us say B, as you can see in this figure, then it is guaranteed to be assumed that the origin of this coordinate system is fixed at this body B. So see this figure, I have taken the origin located at this body B, and so you can say this frame S is associated with the body B, which have been shown in this figure. So in short, you can say that any reference frame in practice is represented by a rectangular coordinate system, and the origin of this system is assumed to be located on the body with which the frame is associated. So now we have to know what are the different types of reference frame. Actually, these reference frames have been defined on the basis of validity of Newton's laws of motion. Or you can say that the origin of reference frame is Newtonian mechanics or Newton's laws of motion. So on the basis of this, reference frame is classified under two categories. And these two categories are what? These are, first one is inertial frame, or you can say inertial reference frame, and the another is non-inertial frame. So first of all, we will discuss what is this inertial frame. As you know, the first law of motion is actually known as law of inertia, because you know the first law of motion gives the concept or idea of inertia, and the name inertial frame comes from this. Actually, this inertial frame is defined as a frame in which Newton's first law of motion is valid, or you can say that it is a frame in which law of inertia holds. Actually, you know, all the three laws of motion proposed by Newton are interlinked. When you say that Newton's first law of motion is valid or it holds in a particular frame, what does it mean? It means the other two laws will also valid in that frame. So in general, we cannot restrict ourselves for defining the inertial frame to the first law, but in general we can define this inertial frame as a frame in which all the three laws of motion are valid. So in short, you can say a frame in which Newtonian mechanics is valid, or Newtonian mechanics or Newtonian laws of motion are valid, is known as an inertial frame. Now we will explain what this definition actually tells us. For the explanation of inertial frame, let us consider that S is a frame associated with the earth, or you can say any other body which is stationary at the earth. Let us say there is a tree which is standing on the surface of the earth, and we associate a frame S with that tree. And let us see this figure, that B is a body lying on the surface of the ground. You can say this body B is lying on the surface of the ground. And this frame S has been denoted by the coordinate system having the coordinate axes OX, OY and OZ. So what we have assumed, that S is a frame associated with the earth, or any other body stationary relative to the earth. As for example, I have told you that there is a building, there is a tree standing on the surface of the earth, and you can associate a frame S with that building or with that tree. And I have assumed that B is a body whose mass is M and it is lying on the surface of the ground. So B is what? This is a body of mass M lying on the surface. When you say surface, it means surface of the ground. So you can see the figure. This body will experience actually two forces. First one is the force of gravity, which is mg, and the another will be the reaction force, that is normal reaction due to the surface on which the body is lying. So the forces acting on the body are what? Forces acting on B. In fact, first one is mg. This is force of gravity, or you can say this is weight of the body. And you know this force of gravity acts in downward direction. So this arrowhead indicates its direction, that it is acting in downward direction. Let us draw a free body diagram of this. You can say this is the mass M and forces acting on it is mg and n. And mg is in downward direction and this reaction n is in upward direction. So n is what? This is in fact normal force or normal reaction. Normal force, and this acts in upward direction. So this arrowhead represents its direction, that it is acting in upward direction. As these two forces acting on our body is in opposite direction, and you know if two vectors are anti-parallel, then the magnitude of resultant of those two forces will be simply the difference of the magnitude of the forces. So you can say the resultant force on B. What will be resultant force on B? If we assume that F is the resultant force acting on this body B, then it will be simply mg minus n, or you can say mg difference n. Now let us assume why it has been written mg minus n. As you know, this force mg is anti-parallel to n, and so the magnitude of resultant will be simply the difference of these two forces. Now let us assume that this mg and n are equal. We assume n is equal to mg. If this is our assumption, then what will be the value of the resultant force? You can see from this equation 1 that this F will be simply 0 in this condition. So we have assumed a body on which the resultant force is 0. Now let us find the acceleration of this body B with respect to the frame S, which we have in fact shown in this figure. So relative to this frame S, now I am going to find the acceleration of this body. Now, acceleration of B relative to S. You know S, we have assumed that this is a frame associated with a tree or a building standing on the surface of the earth. So acceleration of body B relative to S, you know this is denoted by the symbol ABS. What does it mean? It means acceleration of B with respect to S. And this is written as AB minus AS. Now, what are these AB and AS? You know this AB means what? This AB is equivalent to ABG. When you say ABG, it means acceleration of body B with respect to ground. This subscript G stands for ground. And this AS means what? This means ASG. This is acceleration of ASG, not B, ASG. And it means this is acceleration of the frame S with respect to ground. As you know that our body is standing on the surface, is lying on the surface of the earth. And if a body lies on the surface of the earth, what will be its acceleration relative to the earth surface? Definitely it will be zero. And again, you know that we have assumed that ground itself, or a body standing on the surface of the ground, has been assumed as the frame S. So what does this ASG means? It means acceleration of ground with respect to ground. And you know, a body relative to itself is always at rest, and so this will be also zero. So what will be this ABS? You can now substitute these values. This will be simply 0 minus 0, and this equal to 0. So our result is what? Our result is acceleration of body B relative to S, I am now writing only its magnitude, is equal to 0. Or you can write the vector form. So what you have found here? You can see we have assumed a body B on which resultant force is 0, and when we have calculated the acceleration of this body B relative to a frame S, the result is 0. So what happens in this frame S? You can see easily. So in frame S, what event takes place? We see that in frame S, A is equal to 0. I am not writing now ABS. It means ABS already. This is acceleration of the body B. A is equal to 0. A is equal to 0 when resultant force on it F is equal to 0. And do you know what is Newton's first law of motion. Apart from the traditional statement of Newton's first law of motion, when you will express this Newton's first law of motion in terms of the second law of motion, you say that A is zero if F is zero. Actually, that is a Newton's first law of motion. So what is Newton's first law of motion? Newton's first law of motion. You have definitely studied that it is A equal to zero if F is zero. That is the necessary and sufficient condition for acceleration of a body to be zero is that the net force on it should be zero. Or you can say where A is defined as time derivative of velocity. So dv by dt is zero if F is equal to zero. And when you say dv by dt is zero, what does it mean? It means V equal to constant, V equal to constant if F is equal to zero. So actually this is Newton's first law of motion. You know that if this law states that a body will remain either at rest or in motion unless an external unbalanced force acts on it. So when you say that a body is either at rest or moves with constant velocity unless the force acts on it, so this statement can be expressed in nutshell in this condition that A is zero or V is constant if F is equal to zero. So what you have seen here in this frame S, the event which is taking place says that acceleration of this body is zero when F is equal to zero, and this acceleration of the body has been calculated with respect to the frame S. So you can say that Newton's first law of motion is valid in this frame S. And as the definition says, if Newton's first law of motion is valid in any frame, that frame will be an inertial frame. So you can say the frame S, which we have assumed here, is an inertial frame. So you can say, so in frame S, first law of motion is valid. First law of motion is valid. So it is an inertial frame. So you can say that this frame S is an inertial frame. So I hope you have understand the idea of inertial frame. In nutshell, you can say that a frame in which net force on acting on a body is zero, and then relative to a frame its acceleration is zero, then we say that the frame is an inertial frame. Now you can see some remarkable fact regarding the inertial frame. So I am mentioning it in these remarks. First of all, you can see what you have learned, that in inertial frame, Newton's first law of motion is valid. And if Newton's first law of motion is valid in a frame, that frame must be, in fact, either at rest or in uniform motion. So an inertial frame is either at rest or in uniform motion. When you say uniform motion, what does it mean? It means this frame may move with a constant velocity. So an inertial frame is either at rest or in uniform motion. And when you say that motion is uniform, what does it mean? It means acceleration is zero. Because you know if वी इक्वल टू कॉन्स्टेंट. वेन यू से कॉन्स्टेंट इट मीन्स आइदर इट इज जीरो और एनी अदर कॉन्स्टेंट. सो इफ वी इज जीरो देन एक्सीलरेशन ए विल बी जीरो बिकॉज यू नो ए इज इक्वल टू डी बाई डी टी एंड वी इज कॉन्स्टेंट एंड डिफरेंशियल कोफिशियंट ऑफ एनी कॉन्स्टेंट इज जीरो सो ए विल बी जीरो. सो यू कैन से दैट एन इनर्शियल फ्रेम इज एन अनएक्सीलरेटेड फ्रेम. इट हैज़ नो एक्सीलरेशन. सो दिस इम्प्लाइज एन इनर्शियल फ्रेम इज एन अनएक्सीलरेटेड फ्रेम. अनएक्सीलरेटेड फ्रेम ए फ्रेम इन यूनिफॉर्म मोशन और एट रेस्ट विल बी एन इनर्शियल फ्रेम. बट इफ ए फ्रेम इज एक्सीलरेटिंग देन दैट कैन नॉट बी एन इनर्शियल फ्रेम. यू विल सी दैट दैट फ्रेम इज एक्चुअली ए नॉन इनर्शियल फ्रेम. सो इट इज ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्ट दैट एन इनर्शियल फ्रेम इज ऑलवेज एन अनएक्सीलरेटेड फ्रेम. नाउ वी कैन सी that this inertial frame is not unique. You cannot say that there is a body in this universe which is an inertial frame and no other bodies are inertial frame. Actually, when you know a frame S which is an inertial frame, then you can find that the another frame is either inertial or not inertial. You can find it. We simply find acceleration of a frame with respect to a given inertial frame. And if it is found to be zero, then you can say that the second frame is also an inertial frame. So let S equal to an inertial frame, we know it, and S prime, an unknown frame, we don't know this frame is inertial or not, and we have to check this frame S prime is inertial or not. To finding the nature of this frame S prime, that it is inertial or not, we will simply find the acceleration of this frame S prime with respect to the known inertial frame S. So if acceleration of S prime with respect to S. What does this symbol means? It means acceleration of unknown frame S prime with the known inertial frame S is zero. Then S dashed is also an inertial frame. Then this is also an inertial frame. So if acceleration of a frame is zero relative to a known inertial frame, then you can say that unknown frame is also a inertial frame. But if A S prime S is not equal to zero, then this S prime is not an inertial frame. So in brief, you can say that a non-accelerated frame is an inertial frame. Now we have assumed in our discussion that Earth is an inertial frame, but this is a very remarkable fact that in actual practice Earth is not an inertial frame, because you know to be an inertial frame the body should be either at rest or in uniform motion. But you know the Earth cannot be in uniform motion because the Earth has actually two types of motion. It revolves around the Earth and it spins around its axis. And in these two types of motion, neither is rectilinear motion. And in rectilinear motion, only velocity can be constant. So definitely, there will be an acceleration in the motion of the Earth. So actually the Earth is a non-inertial frame, not an inertial frame. Earth is not an inertial frame. in a real sense. But in practice, in so many cases, for simplicity, we treat this earth as an inertial frame. In practice, we treat it as an inertial frame in several situations. But what is the reason behind this? The reason is simply simple, that Earth has although acceleration, but its acceleration is very small, and the observer on the surface of the Earth do not find that Earth is rotating. We always find that Earth is stationary, and this is why if the observer situated on the Earth's surface treats it as an inertial frame, we are not making a large fault. And so in several situations, for simplicity, we treat the Earth as an inertial frame. So you can say, as its acceleration is very small, so we treat it as an inertial frame. Inertial frame. Actually, from Foucault's pendulum experiment, we will actually study this in this problem. So in Foucault's pendulum experiment, it has been clearly proved that Earth is not an inertial frame. So this is all about the inertial frame. Now we will discuss the another reference frame, which is known as non-inertial frame. Non-inertial frame. As the name indicates, that it will be just opposite of the inertial frame. So if you will say all the statements which I have mentioned for an inertial frame in reverse order, then you will find the condition for a frame to be a non-inertial frame. So in nutshell, I am stating here, you have seen that the Newton's first law of motion holds in an inertial frame. So when we will define this non-inertial frame, what we will say? We will simply say that a frame in which Newton's first law of motion, that is law of inertia, does not hold, that frame will be a non-inertial frame. So you can say first law of motion, first law of motion does not hold in a non-inertial frame. Non-inertial frame. And when you say that first law of motion does not hold in non-inertial frame, what are you saying actually? Actually, you are saying that a body on which net force is zero, even then its acceleration relative to a frame is not zero. So what will happen in a non-inertial frame? So in a non-inertial frame, the event will be like this, that F is zero, that is net force on a body is zero, but acceleration of the body relative to a frame is not zero. if such phenomenon takes place in any frame, that frame will be a non-inertial frame. And you can say that when F is zero but A is not zero, what does it mean? It means Newton's first law of motion is not valid. This implies first law of motion is not valid, because first law says that whenever F will be zero, that net force on a body will be zero, then its acceleration must be zero. But if we find in any frame that even when net force on the body is zero but its acceleration relative to that frame is not zero, then we can certainly say that the first law of motion is not holding, is not valid in that frame. And if first law of motion is not valid in that frame, in fact in that condition you can say that frame is a non-inertial frame. So whenever we will test that a frame is non-inertial or not, we will simply take a body on which net force is zero and we will measure the acceleration of the body, and if it is found to be A not equal to zero, we will simply found the acceleration of the body. And if our result will be that acceleration is not zero even when the force is zero, then we will say that that frame is a non-inertial frame. Again, we have seen in the definition of inertial frame that an inertial frame is either at rest or in uniform motion. So what will be the reverse statement? So the reverse statement will be that in a non-inertial frame, a non-inertial frame is not at rest and not in uniform motion, but it will be in an accelerated motion. So non-inertial frames, non-inertial frames are in accelerated motion, accelerated motion. Again, you know acceleration can be zero. A is equal to zero in two conditions. A may be zero in two conditions. This implies the body is either at rest or in a uniform motion. And you know uniform motion is possible, that is motion with constant velocity is possible only when the body will follow a straight line path. So this also implies that motion is rectilinear. Motion is rectilinear. I am not saying that all rectilinear motion are motion without acceleration, but it is possible whenever motion will be rectilinear, only then it is possible that acceleration is zero. So, but when motion is not rectilinear, it takes place on any other trajectory like a circle, like an ellipse, like a parabola or hyperbola. In fact, in that condition, definitely there will be an acceleration. So, on this basis, you can say that a frame which is not following a rectilinear path during its motion will be definitely a non-inertial frame. So, this implies a frame which does not follow rectilinear trajectory during its motion will be a non-inertial frame non inertial frame. And so on this basis you can say that all rotating frames are a non inertial frame. So for an example you can say all rotating frames, that is the frames which are in rotational motion, frames are non inertial. And this is why you can say, since the earth has rotational motion, and so definitely the frame associated with the earth will be a non inertial frame in actual practice, although in for simplicity in several situation due to some specific reason which I have mentioned above, this frame of earth is treated as an inertial frame. But since the earth has a rotatory motion, so the frame associated with the earth is in fact a non-inertial frame. Now we will explain what we have actually told about the non-inertial frame. The main fact is what? The main fact is a non-inertial frame is a frame in which Newton's first law of motion does not hold. And when you say that Newton's first law of motion does not hold, then what we will check? We will check that if F is equal to zero, even then A is not equal to zero. If such a phenomenon takes place in any frame, that is the net force acting on the body is zero, but its acceleration relative to a frame is not zero, then you can say that that frame is a non-inertial frame. So let us see an example here. I have assumed in the explanation of the inertial frame that S is a inertial frame associated with a body standing on the surface of the earth. And we have assumed that there was a body of mass M and the body was B, and two forces were acting on the body. First one was force of gravity mg acting in downward direction. The another force was normal reaction acting in upward direction. And we have actually found that the acceleration of this body B was a zero relative to this frame S, when net force on this, which was F equal to mg minus n, and that was equal to zero. But now let us find the acceleration of this body in another frame. Let us consider there is a vehicle, and this vehicle is actually moving with an acceleration, or you can say a constant acceleration, A, relative to this inertial frame S. And when you say that this is moving with acceleration A relative to S, you are saying that this is moving relative to the earth with an acceleration A. Now let us consider a frame associated with this vehicle, and the coordinate axes we assumed are O prime X prime, O prime Y prime, and O prime Z prime. And let us consider there is an observer in this frame, and this observer is observing the body B. And this observer will actually calculate the acceleration of this body B, and you know the net force on this body B is equal to zero. So now let us consider that I name this frame as S prime. So we have assumed a frame S prime associated with this moving vehicle, and the acceleration of this frame is in fact A relative to S. So let S prime equal to a frame associated with a cart moving with acceleration, A relative to S. Now, you know the net force on body B is zero because we have assumed the body same as in the previous example. Now, net force on B, F is equal to zero. We have already assumed it. Now, we are going to find the acceleration of this body B relative to the frame S prime, which is associated with this moving cart. So, acceleration of B relative to S prime. You will denote this by the symbol ABS prime. This is acceleration of body B relative to S prime. What we can write it? We will write it as AB minus AS prime. AB minus AS prime. You know this AB means ABG, as I have told you earlier. And this ABG means the acceleration of the body relative to the ground. And since the body is lying on the surface of the ground, so definitely its acceleration with respect to ground surface will be zero. So AB is zero, as you have seen earlier. Now, what is this AS prime? AS prime is actually the acceleration of frame S prime relative to the ground. And we have assumed that frame S is associated with ground. So this is actually the acceleration of the body relative to S prime and relative to S, and relative to S its acceleration is not zero, but it is A. So you can see that acceleration of our body B on which resultant force is zero is not zero, but it is minus A. This is a very remarkable fact. So what we are seeing actually in this frame S prime, what event is actually taking place? You can see in frame S prime, F is equal to zero, but A is not equal to zero. So we can say that Newton's first law of motion is not holding in this frame S prime. And you know from definition that if Newton's first law of motion does not hold in any frame, such a frame is called non-inertial frame. So definitely this accelerated frame associated with the cart will be a non-inertial frame. So this result implies that S prime is a non-inertial frame. Non-inertial frame. So in brief, you can say that all inertial frames are unaccelerated frame and all accelerated frames are non-inertial frame. So this is the conclusion, and actually the special relativity is described in an inertial frame, although we have studied about non-inertial frame, but while you will study the special relativity, you will find no use of this non-inertial frame. We will always talk about the inertial frame. So this is all about the reference frame, and we will look forward to some new concept in the forthcoming lecture.